I was working with one of my students today, and we went through all the methods that we could think of summing up non-contiguous data in Excel. So let's start at the first one we thought of. And so I have the numbers separated with nines in between, so you know that we're not catching the nines. And I've copied them all so you can see the different methods of totaling these. So let's go to the sum box here, and we're going to click the automatic sum. And now what we're going to do is we are going to click the first number, and then we are going to press the control button and click the second number, and continue holding the control button and click the third number and hit the final number, and then let go and press enter. And there you have your sum. And that's by using the control thing, the control key in between. The second way we can do it is the same idea. Is we're going to hit our automatic sum button. And now what we're gonna do is we are going to click the first one, and I'm not pressing the control key. What I'm gonna do here is I'm going to key in a comma, and then I'm gonna click on my second key. And I'm going to key in a comma. I'm going to click on my third one and key in a comma. And then click on my last one and put the ending bracket here and then press enter. And once again, you have the second method of totaling these up. Now, the third method is a matter of you need to name the ranges. So I'm going to name each of these, select each of these cells by selecting the first one, pressing the control key. That's the second one, third one, fourth one, and I'm going to name them totals. Okay, and then I press enter to name that range, those ranges. And so now what I'm going to do to sum these up is I'm going to go equals sum, and I'm going to go total. And as you can see, when I'm typing it up, you can see it comes up as a named range. You close that and press enter, and you have the total again. The third way is you can use the FX key, and you can type in sum, press enter, and then you can do it this way. You can, it wants to add up, it wants to already put the whole range in there. But let's not do that. Let's delete that. And what we're going to do is we are going to select the first number, go to the second line, select the second number, go to the third line, select the next number, go to the fourth line, and select this one. And now we say OK. And there you have those summed as well. For the fifth method of doing it, I added range names to this. So I've added this as number, and I've named the first one 1, 2, 3, 4, and I've taken the data in between there. And so what we're going to do, and I've named these numbers here as subtotals. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of these, and I've gone to my data tab, and now I go subtotal. And so I'm changing by when these numbers change, that's when I want to sum, and I want to sum what I've called subs here. And so then we say OK. And there you go. We have, it's not in the right spot, mind you, but it is the same number that is totaled here. So that's all the methods that I can think of adding non-consecutive numbers in Excel. Please subscribe.